Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Let's Play Fallout 3 Game of the Year Edition with Detonol. We are redoing the last part of the game because I figured out how to get my DLC to work. Apparently I needed to activate the data files. Now that is part of the pop-up screen of the Game of the Year Edition where you have a play, options, data files, settings, and help, I think, and exit, I believe. You have to go into data files, and each one of those needs to be included so that you can play the DLC. So now that we have that on, we're going to go ahead and play the game.
You again. I can't say I'm surprised. You and your ilk seem hell-bent on destroying everything our government has worked to achieve. There's nothing to stop me from killing you this time. Let's end this.
This time I could do a different approach.
I beg to differ. The Enclave is at the height of its power. Once this facility is operational, the masses will flock to the Enclave for fresh water, protection, and a plan for the future. You're in over your head, and no amount of talking is going to get you out of it. Once you're dead, we'll finish off this pathetic brotherhood and become the true saviors of the wasteland. This ends now!
Let's go ahead and try that again, because I actually just did this, and that talking
you
point
again
succeeded for me.
Okay, there's nothing.
81%.
The American people are worth fighting for. The future must be secured. I won't let you stand in the way of that.
Oh, no.
If
that's not what I meant to do. Let's load again. This is hilarious now.
You again. There's no...
Okay, give up.
The American...
Success. This one.
And what would you have me do? Let you have everything I've worked to build? Let you destroy it all?
Notice how I'm leveling up now? It's because the DLC's been activated.
And you? You would just let me leave? How can I be sure you won't just shoot me once I've turned my back on you? I suppose it doesn't matter much now. Very well. I shall leave you to your fate.
Why thank you, Colonel Otto, for being understanding.
I guess I shouldn't be surprised that you just let him walk away. It's amazing the world hasn't beaten that out of you. You just better hope it doesn't come back to bite you. Now let's get this place locked down.
Hello?
Dr. Lee, it's right. Sarah Lyons. I'm in the control room. We're both here. What's going on?
I've been monitoring the equipment remotely, and we have a serious problem. The facility has been damaged during the fighting. Some of it looks accidental, some of it may have been sabotage. There's pressure building up in the holding tanks. It needs to be released now, or else the whole facility could explode. To release the pressure, you're going to have to turn the purifier on. Do you understand me? It has to be turned on now! I'm reading this right. I'm afraid there are lethal levels of radiation. Action inside the chamber. I'm sorry. I wish there was some other way, but there's just no time. It has to be done now, or the damage will be catastrophic.
Well, so much for celebrating. One of us is going to have to go in there and turn the damn thing on. And whoever does it isn't coming back out. Not exactly how I imagined going out, you know? So, what should we do? Draw straws?
Fox can start the purifier. That's so messed up.
You're going to have to be quick about it. If the radiation is bad enough, you won't have much time. I won't forget what you've done here. No one will. Thank you.
DLC coming in all at once. Alright, let's finish the game.
And so it was that the Lone Wanderer ventured forth from Vault 101, intent on discovering the fate of a father who had once sacrificed the future of humanity for that of his only child. The Capital Wasteland proved a cruel, inhospitable place, but the Lone Wanderer refused to surrender to the vices that had claimed so many others. The values passed on from father to child. Selflessness, compassion, honor guided this noble soul through countless trials and triumphs. But it was not until the end of this long road that the Lone Wanderer learned the true meaning of that greatest of virtues, sacrifice. Stepping into the irradiated control chamber of Project Purity, the child followed the example of the father, sacrificing life itself for the greater good of mankind. Thankfully, when selected by the sinister president to be his instrument of annihilation, the Wanderer refused. Humanity, with all its flaws, was deemed worthy of preservation. The waters of life flowed at last, free and pure for any and all. The Capital Wasteland, at long last, was saved. So ends the story of the Lone Wanderer, who stepped through the great door of Vault 101 and into the annals of legend. But the tale of humanity will never come to a close, for the struggle of survival is a war without end. And war never changes.
Good narration, Ron Perlman.
Careful now, careful. Don't move too quickly. Everything's fine, you're safe. You're in the Citadel. I was starting to think you might never wake up, despite assurances to the contrary. I've been coming down here every day to see both you and my daughter. It's good that at least one of you has recovered. Yes, yes, she's fine. Oh, she will be. I appreciate your concern for her, but really don't worry. You've been through enough. It's all right, you're safe now. You're in the Citadel. There was some sort of energy spike as the purifier started. You and Sarah were knocked unconscious and brought here to the infirmary. We've been watching over the two of you for days. I'm glad to see it's paid off. Indeed, it did. The tidal basin is full of fresh, clean water now. We've been working to see that it's distributed to as many people as possible across the wasteland. In fact, I'm hopeful that soon we won't be referring to the wasteland any longer. None of this would have been possible without the efforts of both you and your father. I doubt we shall ever be able to truly repay you. Yes, we most certainly did. Between your help in destroying their headquarters and their subsequent defeat at the Purifier, the Enclave was thrown into disarray. Liberty Prime has been assisting our forces in removing any remaining Enclave forces. Just about 2 weeks. Don't worry, we've been taking good care of you. Well, that's really up to you, isn't it? The Brotherhood has a clear plan of action. The remnants of the Enclave must be swept away. The Pride has been working to this end ever since we took the Purifier back. The only remaining question is whether we can count on you to help us. Indeed. We can use every able body available to us. To that end, I'm going to circumvent our standard recruitment procedures and declare you a Knight of the Brotherhood of Steel. Before you do anything else, please speak with Scribe Rothschild. I'm sure he'll be pleased to see you again. He can brief you on the details of the last few weeks, as well as where our efforts are focused now. I understand that you've been through quite an ordeal, but the sooner you can talk to him, the sooner we can put an end to all this. Oh? Have you learned something? Vault 87? Where you found the Geck? We've never been able to penetrate the radiation surrounding that area. This information is invaluable. Well done. As you know, I had my reservations about engaging the Enclave. They did not directly attack us, and I believed we had time. Time to be cautious. Their assault on the Purifier forced our hand. We had no choice but to engage them directly. And once that engagement was begun, we could do nothing but see it through to the end. If they had not considered us a threat before, they do now. So, we have spent the time since you and I last spoke systematically locating and destroying every bastion of Enclave force we can. Liberty Prime has proven far more successful than any of us could have hoped for. My child, you seem to have learned more in the past week than I have in 20 years. She's right here, unresponsive but stable. To see that you've recovered gives me hope. What more did you... Ah, now, that's the real question, isn't it? Our orders were, and are, to acquire any and all advanced technology. And we have, to the best of our abilities. But when I realized the extent of the super mutant threat, I felt it was my responsibility to aid the people in their struggle against them. Unfortunately, my superiors back west disagree with my assessment of the situation. They feel I've grown too attached to the local populace. And they're right. In any event, the Enclave's arrival changes everything. It's been over 20 years since we arrived, and we've been struggling to contain and eradicate the super mutants for nearly as long. With the arrival of the Enclave, I have a terrible feeling the super mutants are the least of our worries. The Brotherhood has taken over control of the Purifier and is managing distribution of the water to the people of the Wasteland. If you travel there, speak with Scribe Bigsley. He's heading up the on-site operation. Please.
All right, guys, we are awake and raring to go.
Another glorious day in this man's army.
I patiently await your word.
Aqua Pura. I do believe that's water coming from the purifier.
Another glorious day in this man's army.
Let's go talk to Scribe Rothschild.
The Brotherhood is at your service.
Nope, not that way.
The Brotherhood is at your service.
Wait, where
the Brotherhood is
this taking me? Do I have a quest active?
At your service.
With Scribe Rothschild. He is over here. Okay. There he is.
Well, it's good to see that you're on your feet again. I assume Lyons is immediately throwing you to the wolves? Has he told you what's been going on while you've been resting? Yes, I believe I can. Step over here for a moment, will you? I'll give you a brief history of what's happened over the last few weeks and what's going on now. As you well know, this all began with the Enclave's occupation of Project Purity here. Thanks to you, their main headquarters here was utterly destroyed. They then suffered a second defeat at the Purifier. Based on a combination of intelligence and field reports, other Enclave locations throughout the wasteland were found. Cut off from their leadership, it was expected that their forces would be in complete disarray. This has not been the case. Based on data and tech gathered from these locations, we've determined that the Enclave forces are still maintaining remote communications. We isolated the transmissions and found their origin point, an old military installation in Rockland, to the southwest. Our advanced scouts have checked over the area, but no easy access to the facility was found. So we're making our own access point. Paladin Tristan is leading the team setting up forward base in an old car tunnel near the site. Once he's settled, Liberty Prime will be deployed. Prime's directive is to neutralize their defenses and create an entry point for the team. The team will move in, eliminate any opposition inside, and cut off their transmitter. Any relevant data should be brought back here. Now, did you have any other questions? If there's anything else you'd like to know, I'll tell you what I can. Otherwise, Paladin Tristan will be waiting. I'll alert him that you're on your way. Performance is exceeding all our expectations. He's been especially effective against the Enclave's vertebirds, for which we previously had no counter. We're fine-tuning his programming as we go, but on the whole, I'm pleasantly surprised. It's as I always suspected. Prime's real issue was energy management. And when Dr. Lee helped us solve that problem, well, the rest was easy.
Could I?
Yes.
Will I? No. Go see Peabody or Bowditch. Don't.
Need something, friend?
Okay, so we now have a quest to go off of, but I already have a quest that I want to complete on my own, and that is to retrieve all the bobbleheads. well, the rest of the bobbleheads in the game. In order to do that, we need to go to the world map. And search for... Let's see if I remember. Wow, look at all these locations. That's right, we need to go to Arafu. Which should be around here somewhere. There it is. Evan King actually has a bobblehead inside his house.
Look what the cat dragged in.
Welcome back to Arafu, kid.
Just in case he's not gonna like this, I'm gonna duck and make sure that he doesn't see me doing it. Now, here is our bobblehead. Repair. Oh, nice. 10 permanent points upgraded. Look at all this ammunition he has. Oh, that makes me lose karma. Let's stop doing that right now.
Keep moving!
Okay, so that is our first bobblehead. Gonna go ahead and make a new save and pause real quick because I don't know how long we've been recording for. Oh, we're only up to 22 minutes. That's good. Which means we can go look for some more bobbleheads. Our next bobblehead will be Vault 108. So, where is Vault 108? Is there any zoom out function? Doesn't look like it. Luckily, I know all of the vault locations. There's 87. Girder Shade. Riverboat Landing. 101. There's 108. So, we're going this way. Where's Minefield? Yeah, we want to start at Minefield because there's something else I would like to get along the way. Did Fox leave my charge? I must have left him back at the Brotherhood or something. I'm gonna have to go back there. Also, we should switch our weapon. Scrapyard! Really doesn't seem to be much going on here, does there? There's zero enemies. Oh, there we go. A couple of enemies and a friendly. Hello. This is exactly what I was hoping for. And now we have dog meat. Let's go, dog meat. We now have a new companion. There really doesn't seem to be much else to this place, does there? So onward we go towards our next bobblehead. Of course I went the way that's impossible to get out. He killed all three, four of these guys? Ah, might have even been five. I have no idea where dog meat went. Let's go back to the scrapyard real quick. I have a feeling that I accidentally made him stay back. Cannot fast travel with enemies nearby. Well, let's solve that problem. There's dog meat. Good. I don't have to go back. Where is our first target? Right there. You're dead. Who's next? Oh wow. There's so many of you. I think I can finally use the sniper rifle and feel good about it. Or the Scope 44 Magnum. Let's see how this works. You're dead. You're dead. There we go, you're dead. Where's the another person? You're dead. Now, I just have one more right in front of me. Oh, maybe a couple more. Wheaton Armory. Something's supposed to go on. Now? Seems to be, except for that Enclave soldier. Ooh, that looked painful. Let's go gather some materials from these people that we just killed. Assault rifle, not bad. Actually, you know what? Where is the Enclave soldier? There he is. Attack, dog meat. What is in here? The Wheaton Armory. Wish I had my radiation suit right about now. Wow, this place is ridiculously high in radiation. Oh, great, and then there's a turret trying to kill me too. Let's fix that problem. Station, zero correct. I love when that happens. Well, none of these match it. Only one correct. Oh, why did I do that? The T matched. So did the D. If anything, collector or instantly would be correct. Wow. I need to retry. Attention? Hey, there we go. First try. Let's go ahead and deactivate the turret system. Open up that, and we need to start using some Rataway. I'm keeping you. Oh, but we picked up enough things to have to eat. So some purified water, blood pack, dirty water, ice cold Nuka-Cola. Terminal. We would have to come back to do this. Well, next level up we get, we are definitely setting our lockpick skill to 100. And probably our science skill. To this place. Let's keep going in the direction we're supposed to. Looks like an abandoned town. although this house is ominously put together. Nope. I thought it might be an actual place where someone lived. What is this place? Looks like some sort of oil area. And we have discovered door to Corvega factory entrance. How come it doesn't register? We can get that bobblehead any old time. I'm gonna go ahead and stop the episode here. But our next episode, we're going into this factory. So, as always, thank you for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in our next episode. Later, guys.